That's what I wanted to make sure. Fuel pumps high off, okay? Mags. Okay, so they're both on the side switch. All right, you ready?
Yep, my man. Here, you gonna shut the door?
I'm just gonna start this one first.
Which one? Left. Left. All right.
one out of two can see that.
We need to pull the cowl off and probably clean the fuel lines out. It's running right down this rail right here. So that means...
it's coming out from right here.
Yeah.
Coming out from right there.
Where's the fuel? You see the fuel lines running in over there?
No, it's actually feels like behind a panel or something. I mean, it's all up in there.
Yeah, that's the fuel pump. Oh, that's the fuel pump right there.
I got right here.
Alright. You see a light? Where's your
light?
Yeah.
See, there's fuel there on top.
Well, that's where we're turning out from.
Do you want me to go cut
the fuel? And there's the fuel pump. Where's the line going out of the pump, though?
I think it might be coming from right there.
Well, before we can pull
the fuel pump,
we have to drain the gas out of this wing.
Because if we don't,
it's going to get really, 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 really messy. I think there's... 5-10 gallons of fuel in here, so we're gonna take it out of this wing and put it over there where we changed the gasket in, so that we can see if that side leaks, and then cut the fuel out of here so that we can actually take the fuel pump out and change it out. Anyways, this is going to take a while.
Put a little German torque on it.
Just
put that in there.
Yeah, just put them on.
Yeah. This right is going to be the...
You had O-rings.
Those are flat, something like that.
Yeah. All right.
Now we gotta get it in.
do with my nut and bolts.
I could find this little nut and bolt for this ground. Forgot what I'd done with it.
Do what now?
I'm missing a nut and bolt for this ground for the fuel pump.
Did you set it down or something?
I don't. Well, when I took it off, I did something with it.
Don't start that mess.
So. I can't remember if I put it up here or put it in the truck, but now
I gotta go find it.
All right, almost done. I'm gonna put that through this and through right here. That hole right there. That is tight. Oh, I gotta get this clamp on. Who said working on airplanes was easy?
While we're waiting on him, gonna have to clean all this stuff up, and then like all your grease fittings, gonna have to grease all these fittings and make sure that they take grease, and if they don't take grease, then I have to take the grease nipples out and redo them.
This hose right here real quick. Remember how it was?
Yeah, let's take it loose
blow
and
up.
See.
And so take it out, probably cut these off real quick.
It's right here.
Heavy duty cutters.
Grab that end of the hose.
The hose or the?
The tube. You're pulling the red off.
Orange?
The orange or the, yeah.
So close. So close. I'm not going to scratch it, scratch it. There it is. That's hot. Perfect. Just like new. Just like new. Back through there and hook it back up to here. Just like it was meant to go on there, right there. Look at that.
Boy, that grommet is rough. Nice. We might need to get a new grommet eventually.
All right, that's German torque on that. Good and tight. Zip tie this thing down. That's a good spot for it. There you go. There's more fancy stuff for you. You know, these magnetos look better than the ones that were on the 182.
Do what?
after sitting for 14 years. Finally cranked up, ran rough our mags. The right mag on this engine is going to have to be overhauled because it was not handling dropping out. This one sounded a little janky, but maybe it just needs to be ran more, but we will test that out. Now we're going to be doing our compression check. So you get your cylinders good and hot, hook this fancy stuff up, blow air into it, and then you measure to see how much compression you lose. So put your right here and let you watch.